Good morning to Mr. Rakesh and everyone. Today we'll be presenting about technology from Shiseido in their product. Before we start our presentation, let me quickly introduce our members. The first part, Lenson will be introduction and the conclusion part. Then following is Alex and Amelia, they were doing the technology part. Then me, Kishan and Kelly will be doing the discussion part. Then Ron will be doing the recommendation part. Now I'll pass to Lenson to do the presentation of introduction.
For the introduction part, Shiseido was a Japanese international personal care company for hair care, skin, cosmetic, and perfume. Shiseido is considered as one of the oldest personal care company in the world and is a leading Japanese cosmetic product that has been processed for more than one century. Shiseido was founded by Orinobu Fukuhara in 1872 in the area of Ginza of Tokyo. They performed as the first Western-style pharmacy in Japan. The name of Shiseido is get from the Chinese phrase, which means admire the qualities of the great earth which nurture new life and brings forth new values. Shiseido is now the largest company in Japan and the fifth largest company in the world. Now I will pass my part to Alex.
Hi everyone, my name is Alex. I'm going to present about one of the technology strategies of Shiseido. Shiseido has successfully developed the first web force technology in the world and applied in their popular product, which is the Ultimate Sun Protection Lotion WebForce SPF 50+. Its advanced technology has taken its latest innovation to the next level. When it exposed to the water or sweat, the film of sunscreen on the skin becomes smoother, and the uniformly spread layer on the skin can enhance the protective effect and give a better UV protection. In addition, this can prevent the skin from harmful UV rays, so the consumer can enjoy the outdoor activities even under the hot sun without having the risk of sunburn. Besides that, this is their proprietary sunscreen formulation, which then has successfully include the ionic mineral sensor in its developer. After mixing with the mineral ion, the ionic mineral sensor can enhance the UV protective layer become stronger. Also, it applies an exclusive formulation. The negatively charged ion in the sensor, which bond with the positively charged ion of the sweat or water, to form a strong ionic bond and become smoother, stronger, and more uniform layer on the skin. So it made the UV protective layer more effective when it firstly applied and tend to improve the UV protective effect. On top of that, to apply uniformly spread layer of sunscreen, it sunscreen active ingredient involving the UV protective component would absorb or disperse UV light. It also enables the UV absorber to convert UV energy into several forms, such as the light or heat, which are risk-free for the consumer. Furthermore, this can help to reduce the damage on the skin and prevent leaving the white residue on the skin and give a better texture to the consumer. Now, to talk about Amina.
Also can protect the surface area and advantage for dry skin. Consumer will notice it when they apply it, they have a slightly dryness feel. So if it might cause consumer have skin dryness than consumer have before. This sunscreen is not suitable for every skin type as it does not 100% protect skin despite its claims. There are different skin types such as allergy and ants. They should avoid products that contain preservative or fragrance, and also avoid sunscreen that containing alcohol. The Shiseido Red Force Ultimate Sun Protection received a score of 40, which earned it a fair rating for the overall performance in consumer reports. As the top rating is excellent, very good, good, fair, and low. So it is actually average rating for Shiseido. It is not an impressive product, it's because its market price is $40. $40 for 3.3 ounce per bottle. While consumers pay for a higher price when they buy a sunscreen that earns only a fair rating. So especially when consumer because state that certain products that cost far less and perform better than this product. And so there are misleading claims which Shiseido better when applied. Claims is misleading. This like they say that the Shiseido sunscreen product is Shiseido sunscreen product in water will enhance the effect of the sunscreen. Since it shows no improvement in the test, protection in the test. This will also potentially harm if consumer interpret the claim to mean that they no need to reapply the sunscreen when they get out of water. Besides, this may also damage the reputation of the company as consumers trust the product and they use it without reapplying it after using the product, and they trust that they can be protected by the product to block the UVA and UVB. There are also some labeling issues which they does not clearly stated that how long of the sunscreen effect will last in their product. Meanwhile, they stated in their product that the sunscreen will become more effective when it comes into contact with water. There was no increase in UVB after 80 minutes as they claim that to be water resistant. This would cause bad user experience for consumer as they do not know how many hours that the effect of the sunscreen will last. So Shiseido should display the instruction on their product labeling, such as reapply frequently to maintain the protection, especially after perspiring, swimming, or toweling, to let consumers know that how long the effect will last and they should apply it after how many hours. I'll pass to Kishan for the next slide.
Hi, my name is Kishan. Now, talking about this session for the ProFancy Nail Trademark Technology. This technology is to prevent the skin from taking damage from the ultraviolet. Not just that, it also help customers to prevent having the appearance of wrinkles and uneven skin tone. So as we all know, today customers, they prefer products that allow them to look younger and not to have any wrinkles. Because they are taking good care of their appearance, they don't want to look young or they grow up. One of the functions they prefer is the anti-aging. But customers also are emphasizing on the ingredients itself, the function that can help them to look younger, to prevent from having any wrinkles, etc. And also the technology the company are using. One of the shader using the this proven technology is the is about the anti-aging function. According to Trusty Blue, he mentioned that our skin will become thinner and lose its fat. So this will cause our skin to sag and grow fine lines. A doctor who named Channing Barnett, he suggests that customers should actually use moisturizer to protect and hydrate their skin instead of keep applying the anti-aging product, as it would cause some bad effects such as having redness, having burn, etc. Next, I'll talk about the trademark issue. According to Upstore, he said that the trademark is connecting with an unregistered mark and to inform the potential infringers that a logo, slogan, term, or any other indicator that are being claimed as a trademark. Trademark symbols will not be guaranteed that it will be protected under the trademark laws. So this proven CEL technology could easily get imitated by shader competitors. Competitors will then imitate this technology and come up with similar function that shader using this proven CEL. So this will cause shader will not have any competitive advantages. So shader will be no longer the only company to have this technology. Shiseido could still use this technology, but the registration of trademark will get refused. If Shiseido did not successfully register as a trademark, the product would definitely get imitated. Next, I'll talk about the labeling confusion. According to Smithers, most of the sunscreen product has a lot of labeling confusion. Customer did not get much information from the product. So where these sun creams are meant to protect the skin from UVA and UVB, if customer did not read the instruction or they did not get much instruction from the company, they overuse the product, this could increase the risk of having skin cancer. The instruction of labeling does not explain well, so a customer could easily use it a lot of time a day. So this would cause customer to have some effect as well, like redness, burn, etc. Now, to sum up, this technology might seem good to certain group of customers, but also quite harmful to another type of customer, as nowadays we have a lot of different types of skin types, where this customer might feel allergic to this product, or this customer might feel allergic to some of the chemical they're using inside this product. Now I'll pass to Ron about the recommendation.
Hello sir, I'm going to talk about the recommendation. This is the recommendation. Shiseido should remove the alcohol from the workforce technology where it contains a small alcohol of alcohol in the workforce technology where it will irritate people's skin with skin sensitive. And researchers also researched that the longer the skin exposed to alcohol, the greater the aging effect, where 2 days of exposure to alcohol is more bad than 1 day. Shiseido can use alcohol-free ingredient to make it better, so that everyone can use without fear of the aging effect of in their skin. Besides, Shiseido also can improve it by adding an anti-aging ingredient in the workforce technology to prevent the skin from getting damaged. Next, Profan cell technology should improve on the colors where most of the customers did not like the pale color in the Shiseido UV Protection Foundation, where Shiseido can improve it by changing the color of the foundation. Last but not least, improve the texture by softening the foundation. Shiseido can improve them by softening the texture, which help customer easily to get the right amount of the powder on their brush. Next, I will pass it to Lian Shen.
In conclusion, although Shiseido is an Asian brand, but they also do focusing in America and Euro market. Shiseido performance is now positive and have a good situation for extra growth and development. Shiseido is now succeeding in the technology to keep their business to be competitive in this world. That's all is our presentation. Thank you for listening.
Q&A, anyone who will answer, and you should have different members' mic to answer. First one is Web Force, the first product you presented. The product is about $40 for 3.3 ounce. Can you get anyone and discuss about the target audience for this product?
For people like to enjoy the outdoor activities.
Anyone give me more details? I need to know more demographic, psychographic details about the target audience.
The young,
use my force.
The youngest. Because they like to play with their friends in the outdoor and like in the beach.
Okay.
So they need to use the UV protection product to protect their skin.
Okay, we know that that's very general. Now the price is $40. What kind of income range they should have? Give me more details.
Maybe high income because their price is very high compared to other sunscreen product.
So they are young and with high income.
Not say very young, but those people who like outdoor activities, like because the American country, the America and UK, right? There are many people like outdoor activity, like they going to beach for volleyball or something, they can use
it. Okay. Now, I want to know about the labeling issue. So we know that the product has to be reapplied a few times. And something like this is not stated on the packaging. Do you think it's a good idea to state it on the packaging? What do you think? Anyone?
Yes, I think it's a good idea if you speak clearly of the instruction on the product. Because you never know, our skin will have different condition, the same product. So it's better if the company apply the instruction and then to tell us one day how many times should we apply. Because if a company, if a customer have a dry skin, they will keep applying until they feel that, oh, I feel hydrated already. But then it's not the way. Companies should still provide the instruction.
So if the company have put those instructions on that labeling, so consumer will clearly know how long they need to apply, need to reapply it, or this type of sunscreen, is it suitable for their skin type? So they will be more clear about the sunscreen for now.
The next question is the
EV
meters. You mentioned earlier there could be EV meters when you copy your product. And they will lose competitive advantage. How to deal with this? Because anyone can copy any product very easy. How to solve this problem or deal with this problem?
As I mentioned that if Shiseido did not successfully register as a trademark, so what I can say is Shiseido should continue and fight for their the right to use of having this technology itself. They should keep on register until it's successful. Meanwhile, during this process of registration, definitely some companies will imitate this kind of similar technology, but Shiseido can still fight hard to earn their trademark.
Okay,
to earn their registration.
Okay, so treatment you can have, but like they still create something similar in your product. How to discourage the competitors to copy your product? Is there anything you can do besides having trademark? Even though you have trademark, what you, other brands can copy, or people who are making fake products in China could copy. How to stop it? Is there a mechanism you can put your product?
Maybe they even more different technology inside the product, as they are the first to create the WebForce technology, and then while other competitors trying to imitate the WebForce technology, they can try to put more effort in adding some new ingredients or some good chemicals to let the WebForce more stronger. I mean, like the effect is more stronger than other competitors, as other competitors may or just only imitate at the first stage of the product.
Okay, alright, let's look at that.
Thank you.
Thank you.